Brothers and sisters, I am not ashamed of the gospel. It is the power of God for the salvation of everyone who believes, for Jew first and then Greek. For in it is revealed the righteousness of God from faith to faith. As it is written, the one who is righteous by faith will live. The wrath of God is indeed being revealed from heaven against every impiety and wickedness of those who suppress the truth by their wickedness. For what can be known about God is evident to them, because God made it evident to them. Ever since the creation of the world, his invisible attributes of eternal power and divinity have been able to be understood and perceived in what he has made. As a result, they have no excuse, for although they know God, they did not accord him glory as God or give him thanks. Instead, they became vain in their reasoning, and their senseless minds were darkened. While claiming to be wise, they became fools and exchanged the glory of the immortal God for the likeness of an image of mortal man, or of birds, or of four-legged animals, or of snakes. Therefore, God handed them over to impurity through the lusts of their hearts for the mutual degradation of their bodies. They exchanged the truth of God for a lie, and revered and worshiped the creature rather than the Creator, who is blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The heavens proclaim the glory of God.
The heavens proclaim the glory of God.
The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament proclaims his handiwork. Day pours out the word to day, and night to night imparts knowledge. Not a word nor a discourse whose voice is not heard. Through all the earth their voice resounds, and to the ends of the world their message.
The heavens proclaim the glory of God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
After Jesus had spoken, a Pharisee invited him to dine at his home. He entered and reclined at the table to eat. The Pharisee was amazed to see that he did not observe the prescribed washing before the meal. The Lord said to him, O you Pharisees, although you cleanse the outside of the cup and the dish, inside you are filled with plunder and evil. You fools, did not the maker of the outside also make the inside? But as to what is within, give alms, and behold, everything will be clean for you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Christ. kind of puts the section of the reading from this letter that we've heard today into a context. So Paul's letter to the Romans is his longest work, and he goes into much detail to help the Christian community continue to thrive and to grow. Particularly in this passage, he speaks about the wrath of God being revealed from heaven against every impiety and wickedness. Now, impiety is not giving justice to God, that is, not offering worship to God, not giving ourselves over to God. And when we are not in right relationship with God, and we're not making God first in our lives, there, that kind of falls into not having right relationships with one another and with other people. We fall into wickedness. And all of that leads eventually to the suppression of truth itself. So Paul is identifying here the path that we want to definitely avoid. And then the opposite being the path by which we can live good, wholesome lives is to give first and foremost worship to God, to surrender our wills to God our Father, to be in right relationship with Him, especially through the sacraments of confession and Holy Communion, so that strengthened by the presence of God and our right relationship with Him, we have the grace to be able to love others the way in which God has loved us. And so in a way, Jesus is saying a similar thing to the Pharisees. It's not just what we do externally, it's what's going on inside of our heart. And so we need to take the time each day to make sure that our heart, our mind, our consciousness begins to be connected with the Lord, so that His disconnectedness, the consciousness of His presence with us, will allow Him to do His work within us and also to do His work through us. As we gather together today, the confidence in the Father's love, we bring our needs to Him.
For an increase in religious vocations, may the Lord bless those discerning priesthood or consecrated life with generous and open hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all public authorities, leaders of nations and governments, and those entrusted with the welfare of their people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are dealing with the scars of war, conflict, or violence, may the healing power of Christ restore their hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the community gathered here, may the Holy Spirit continue to guide us in our daily lives and decisions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the hope of rising with Christ, may they soon rest in His peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Laura St. Vinay, Carolyn Stanger, Emily and Daniel Strinkowski, Craig Failing, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intentions of Pat and Mary Cahill, for which this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, we ask you to hear these prayers and grant them in accordance with your most holy will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
your word to whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and Lord of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will again for your holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, you declare your glory, as with one voice we declaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, your God of all holiness. Therefore, we are for reasons to be present and now the Spirit of our elected people, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of it, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, the most Lord giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of the faith, we proclaim
your death, O Lord, and the glory of your resurrection, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the Lord's death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have helped us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be added into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and also our bishop, his assistant bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of the faith. graciously grant her peace and unity according to your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The rich suffer want and go hungry, but those who seek the Lord lack no blessing.
I
defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.